The intense campaign to be the next governor of Virginia is giving rise to a third-party candidate.
And after more mudslinging in last night's debate, there's a growing sense the race could be decided by a Libertarian candidate. Our Northern Virginia Bureau Chief, Jeff Goldberg, is here to explain. Jeff?
Well, Maureen, Robert Sarvis has been in the race for months now, but his name is really just starting to get some attention as he's gaining some traction in the polls. But it may be more of a reflection of how voters feel about the other two candidates.
Can't vote for these guys.
Of all the political ads you've seen lately, this is probably the one you've seen the least.
I'm Robert Sarvis, and I joined this race to give you a better choice.
Libertarian Robert Sarvis, a lawyer, software developer, and one-time Republican, says the negative accusations between Cuccinelli and McAuliffe
and a sharp increase in the most personal of attacks.
It's overwhelmingly negative. It is unbelievably false.
Make him the perfect alternative.
So there's really nobody other than me to be proud to vote for. And so that's one of the reasons why people are receptive to my message.
But can he win? Sarvis thinks he has a shot, but the polls suggest otherwise. The latest poll from the Washington Post and NBC News shows Sarvis is well behind the leaders, but still at a solid 10%.
That's not because they like him. It's because they don't like the two candidates.
James Homan with Politico says Sarvis, the former Republican, will take more votes from one candidate, Cuccinelli.
In a race that's close, in a race that's within the margin of error, there's no question he could end up making a difference.
Have you heard of Robert Sarvis?
I have not.
I'm not familiar with him.
Democrat Sandy Welch likes having Sarvis in the race.
I'm just a believer that it's good to have different voices.
While Republican Terry Argenbright knows it could hurt his guy.
That bothers me.
Now, Sarvis is trailing both Cuccinelli and McAuliffe by millions in fundraising, but he says the numbers are climbing and he hopes to be included in the third and final gubernatorial debate next month in Blacksburg. Jeff Goldberg, ABC 7 News.